Scots have been making whisky for centuries. It's a tradition refined over the years by generations of skilled master craftsmen so that every dram, be it single malt, blend or liqueur, is a small glass of history in its own right. It might surprise you to know that for such a complex and varied drink, Scotch whisky is made using just three ingredients: malted barley, yeast and water. First, the barley is malted by being steeped in water, then spread out to help it sprout and germinate, producing the sugars that will turn to alcohol later on. The sprouting barley is then dried in a kiln, sometimes fired by peat, which gives it the smoky flavours found to varying degrees in the final whisky. The kiln's traditional pagoda-shaped chimney is the distinctive hallmark of a Scottish distillery. Once dry, the barley gets milled and mixed with hot water in a mash tun to create wort, the sugary, non-alcoholic liquid that's the foundation for malt whisky. The real magic begins when the wort is transferred to the large vats known as wash vats. Yeast is then added to kickstart a chemical reaction that converts the wort sugars into a low-strength alcoholic liquid called wash. The wash traditionally gets distilled in two large, distinctive copper stills that act like giant kettles, sending alcohol vapours up the swan neck to condense in pipes cooled by cold water. The liquid runs off from the second still into the spirit safe, which is kept locked, courtesy of customs and excise, to make sure every drop distilled is accounted for and taxed accordingly. Because the master distiller is unable to smell or taste the alcohol as it runs into the safe, it's at this point his skill really comes into its own. Judging by sight alone, he separates the high-quality middle run of the new spirit from the lower grade fore and aftershots. Once distilling is complete, the new spirit is poured into casks, and now it's time for the hardest part, the waiting. Whisky is matured in bourbon or sherry oak casks for a minimum of 3 years before it can legally be called Scotch. Many whiskies are matured for much longer, often for a decade or more, slumbering in dark, damp warehouses, where over the years the wood of the casks and the surrounding atmosphere gives the whisky its colour, character, and just some of its natural flavours. Using his trained palate, the master distiller will decide when the maturing whisky is ready and fit for finishing and bottling. While the basic distillation process is the same across Scotland, subtle variations in the ingredients and the microclimate, local preferences and technique, and even the shape and size of the stills at different distilleries all contribute to the huge range of flavours and characteristics produced and which vary from region to region. Lowland whiskies are known for their delicate, malty, citrusy character, while Highland malts tend to be more robust with nutty notes, hints of honey, and if the distillery is near the sea, some salty maritime influences creep in. Speyside is renowned for its fruity single malts, and there's no mistaking Islay whiskies, which are usually heavily peated and have a wonderful, warming, smoky character. Campbelltown whiskies, on the other hand, have a curious mix of characteristics ranging from peat-flavoured to dry or salty. So whether you're a whisky novice or you're already a bit of a connoisseur, this fine spirit has hidden depths just waiting to be explored and discovered. Slange it.